I'm going to use cyberduck.io instead of FileZilla. FileZilla is really easy program, but I found that Cyberduck is even quicker and easier, and it doesn't mess up my computer. Sometimes FileZilla doesn't work. It doesn't upload. That's what I found. So on the cyberduck.io, come down to the bottom down here where it says download, download. There's the Windows download, and this is the Mac download. All right, so here's the duck right here, cyberduck.app. I'm going to go to my website, webskins.com, and I'm going to make a new folder on my server called Fantasy, which you'll see that I didn't make it yet, and there's nothing there yet, and that's what I want you guys to do. You can use your .com as your front page. You can start making maybe a portfolio website for yourself. That'd be great. And then you can, instead of sending me that .com, you send me .com/ whatever the folder name is to see that website that you're working on. So you can have multiple websites on your server. So let's open up the Cyberduck. And this is what it looks like. If you have anything here, you can delete these bookmarks. We're going to make a new bookmark for your server. Come down here to the plus sign, click on it, and we're going to nickname your site. Mine is webskins.com. Your server is going to be webskins.com. Your nickname could be .com, it could be just webskins, doesn't matter. So your server, this is where you're going to be uploading to, webskins.com, and your port is 21. So instead of webskins.com, that could be yourname.com. That's what you're going to put there. You're going to put your username for uploading to the server right here. And then path is very important. This is where you're going to be putting it, where you're going to be putting all of your files into the server. There are folders called public_html, www, public_ftp, and you want to probably put it in your public_html usually. I think GoDaddy is that way too, I'm not sure, but I'm not going to put a path there right now. I'm going to show you why you need to put a path there though, okay? So then I'm going to close this, click on the little X here to close it, and double click here, and I'm connected. Like I said before, this is your public HTML right here, and this is where all my files are. So if you were to go back, click this close and open it again, okay, connection, you can connect to server, new bookmark, delete it, edit the bookmark. Let's edit the bookmark now. I right-clicked on that so you know. I right-clicked right here, and then edit bookmark. So now I can edit the bookmark. I can put in where the path is. I can write public_HTML. That's where it's going to go. Close it. Now double click on here and I go right into that public HTML folder. Okay, if I go back, if I click on here and click on that right here, this is going up a root directory. So does that look familiar? That looks like what we did before, right? And we want to be inside of this folder, the public HTML. So that's where I want to be in here. Okay, so this is really simple. Here's the remote, here's the hosting. I just want to put a new folder in here. It's really simple, it's ridiculous. Open my Web 1 folder, and you'll see that I have the Fantasy website right here. I'm just going to drag this Fantasy website. Make sure you have all lowercase. I like to make everything lowercase. It's a lot easier, quicker to remember where your stuff is if you name your stuff. You'll notice in my server over here, everything is lowercase except for this one. But all of these are lowercase, so I remember. And instead of spaces, I put underscores. So I'm just going to drag this folder, Fantasy, over here, not onto a folder like this, but over the regular HTML pages and JPEGs. Just drop it right there. You don't want to drop it inside of a folder, you're gonna lose it. Authenticating as WebSkins. It's doing it. Waiting. And there you go. It upload is complete. It says it right here. Let's go over here to the FTP and we'll see down here where it says Fantasy. Open that up. I have a lot of files, right? And I have my index page and my images. Inside the images folder, I have my Fantasy. You can double click on that and you can see it just this way. Now let's go back to my website where it says fantasy, press enter. And look at that, there's my website. Woohoo! It's my first website. Right click, view page source. And then you can see my code.